Now this is probably going to be the most sacrilegious video that I've ever made. As a professionally trained violinist, I'm going to self-teach viola in an hour. Don't make viola jokes, don't make viola jokes. And I can give up all the hopes I had that you're going to ever take me seriously as a classical musician. So, my first minute on the viola. So I've tuned it to my violin. Let's see if it's still tuned because it's a new instrument. So actually the G, D and A string are the same pitch as the violin. The violin just has the higher E and the viola has the lower C to it. And obviously it's bigger. So I'm going to try to be comfortable because what you notice is that it's slightly heavier. A violin is around 400 grams to max 500. Viola kind of starts at 500 and to 700 or above, depending on what size. And in this video, I like to answer all your questions about violin versus viola, playing viola as a violinist. Like, do you need a lot of strength or force? Is it really hard or whatever, how is reading the clef? So I'm going through all of that while, you know, trying it myself. So let's try to just draw a sound for the first minute. So the bow is obviously a little bit heavier and stiffer. So it feels kind of chunky, so to say, a bit heavier for my hand. I do like it without the shoulder rest, kind of. We'll see how that goes throughout the first hour. So I'm really trying to find the right contact point. The contact point is obviously, as the instrument is larger, it's more in the direction. Feels different for the right arm, definitely feels different for the left arm. So it's not only a heavier instrument, but it's a bit further away. On the other side, you know, in terms of force, you know, people play the cello and the double bass and you don't put it under your chin, but you don't need much force, but you really need to kind of lean in the string. So the smoothening of the bow change and frog is harder. Well, it feels different because the string also has less tension, so you have the idea that you're really kind of sinking into the string. You see, I'm scratching at the frog because the bow is very heavy here. Far away to bow at the tip, so I'm slanting it a little bit to be able to use the whole bow. Bow shakes. Yeah, that's because the tension is a little bit lower of the string, so you hour challenge is maybe not the smartest idea because it's already starting to get a bit heavy. Now, in the next 10 minutes, I'll just play some really slow scales, focusing on getting the fingers right. And getting the sound right. And kind of getting to know the notes, because we have Now, confusing thing here is that on the violin, if you play a semitone, you can kind of safely put your fingers really close together that they're really touching each other. On the viola, you have some space in between and you need to learn how big that space is. And what I learned from when I was working in the violin studio, there was also a viola teacher, like a real violist. And what she explained about left hand is, if you have, you know, normal hands, small hands, in violin lessons we learned that we should put the fingers like all on the string. But on the viola, certainly if you would have small hands, it's not possible. So what you do is make this movement, you see? This round, yeah, like you're knocking a door, so to say. A bit like vibrato, actually. And so, yeah, I try to have more of a giving hand. Support the viola a little bit with my left hand, because I don't want all of it to be, you know, for your neck it's really heavy. If you do everything with your neck, so like you would play without a shoulder rest, you support more with your left hand. And then for the fourth finger, make this movement and just leave the index finger. I don't know if I'm doing it right. Find a different position, and that's the thing about self-learning, that you have to kind of invent the wheel, so that's not really smart, and that's why soon I'm going to learn it properly with the awesome violist Milan, who's the principal violist of the Metropolitan Opera in New York, and I'm collaborating with him to create a course for violinists who want to switch to the viola or play the viola on the side. Then I'm going to learn it properly. So the link is in the description if you want to get on the waiting list of this wonderful course with Milan and me being on your side, having the same problems. So this is after 10 minutes of practicing scales and sound. This B flat, so a semitone from an open string, was quite challenging, because on the violin you really have this clear reference point, while on the viola you feel like you have a bit of a second position feeling, like you're in nowhere, no man's land. Out of tune, but I like this cello-like sound. This is, by the way, a Fiddlerman Artist viola, and I've picked this one because I didn't want a really expensive one for trying out, but I also didn't want a cheap one, because, you know, if you play viola as a violinist and you have a very nice violin, and then you get kind of a, I don't know, a cheap viola, then you know, it's for your motivation, then you'll just start hating the viola. So but this is, comes in a bit complete with a bow and case and lots of accessories, a little over $800, and I think that's a great deal if you if you're looking for an instrument that doesn't break the bank but also is just a good sounding instrument, because you want a beautiful viola sound. That's why you play viola. So if you have a cheap, bad sounding viola, then, you know, what's the fun? And you can also rent some. This, by the way, 16 inch. And that means that the body is like 40 centimeters, and for the violin, a violin is 14 inch to compare it with viola sizes. But as an adult, you can go for a 15 inch or maybe even a 14 inch, then it's exactly the same as a violin. Or you can go for a large 16.5 inch. 16 is just, yeah, I think it plays well. I do notice that my arm gets a bit tired, but I guess as a budding violist, I should train some muscles. So as a violist, you can encounter three different clefs. The normal violin clef that indicates the G. Then you have the viola clef, and how it reads is the viola clef indicates the C, which is in the middle line in your sheet music, where normally a B would be. But it's not the C, like one note higher than the B, but it's actually the C seven notes lower. So if you see a note in viola sheet music, it's seven notes lower. So what you can think is just think one note higher and then an octave below. And what I recommend when you start playing the viola is, because there is this trick that you can read it as if it is the third position on the violin and then just play it in the first position on the viola, but then you have no idea what notes you play, and then try to read an orchestra score with five flats or something. You would do good if you're playing these simple things that you play as a beginning violist, so to say, that you really are aware of, okay, what is the note name of this? And so you make this connection between the notes you see, the note name, and actually the grip, the fingering on your instrument, because otherwise you'll really get very confused later on. So now I'm going to practice another 50 minutes and see how far I get. And I'm going to practice the viola part of the orchestra score from Vivaldi Autumn Concerto. So there we start with a note that looks like the G on the violin, but it's actually an A. And so the A seven notes lower. So that would be the open A string, and it looks like on the violin the G second finger in the first position on the E string. Okay, so that's how it works. So we see the B flat here, that is placed on the height of the A that you would see in violin sheet music. So it's one note lower, but remember that it's not a one note difference, but it's a seven note difference. Okay, but it does help to think, okay, if I see a note, I must think one note higher and then an octave lower. That's kind of a good calculation. And then later on you can, you know, see it in one go. Now, let's get started. So practice scales, but you know, these jumps are something different. It feels a bit like how you play tenths on the violin, because you're if I place the first finger as low as my hand, then it's hard to reach the fourth finger. So what helps me is to stretch down that first finger a little bit. My first three bars as an orchestra violist. So let's try that again. Comes the next note, which is looks like G. Yeah, it's just one octave lower, but I'm now confused where it is. Well, let's see. So it must be an A. And then I have to go to an E, so it's C.
doesn't cost me much effort to create the sound with the bow. It does feel a little bit more chunky, but I mainly feel that the instrument itself is heavy, and that my arm, you know, a violin you have nice and close with you, and then this is a little bit further away. So if you want to have that feeling, then maybe just grab your violin and place it a little bit here, and then you'll get a little bit of the feeling. So I'm playing the viola now for half an hour. And I have gone a bit further with the autumn. What I find challenging is that you're playing a middle voice in the orchestra. And that means that your part doesn't really sound like a recognizable melody, which you also have if you're playing second violin. And as I mostly play first violin parts, and actually I find playing second violin harder, that you really have to read, and it's a different clef, and you really have to read. So it's kind of challenging, but it's already getting better, and mainly if I see alterations or big jumps, then I really have to calculate. So here's how the Vivaldi is going. Second thing I've been doing is that I have picked up, very cheesy, the swan. Now, position shifting is really a challenge. Alterations, really have to think about it. Which note do I start? Let's see how that goes in half an hour. Now, I'm now a 1 hour violist. I didn't take a break, didn't take coffee in between. And this is how my fingers look. So you see, kind of, but maybe it's because it's new strings, it doesn't feel painful or anything. I did switch the shoulder rest back on somewhere in between, did some stretching, and the reading in the clef is a little bit more comfortable, but obviously not as comfortable as the violin clef, but you know, I've been reading this now for an hour, and reading the violin clef for like almost 30 years, so that doesn't compare. In terms of the orchestra part, this is how it's going. How the swan is going. I've discovered that a low bow speed kind of gets me a more resonant and a full sound. So that helps. Now, that is as good as it gets. It's an hour on the viola. I still think I have a violinist's vibrato. It should be wider and slower. Perhaps I try it. And sometimes the transitions are jerky because I'm just stressing out like, okay, what's this next note? What's this next note? But, it's a great instrument with little changes, relatively little changes in technique. To learn a new instrument that sounds different from the violin. So it's an enrichment, I think. And, you know, after an hour, you know, I have no illusions that I'm good at the viola now or anything. But it kind of surprises me how easy I get used to the clef. And also to the instrument. I think my tone has become better than half an hour ago. So yeah, it was fun, and I'm looking forward following the course that I'm making in collaboration with Milan, the principal violist of the Metropolitan Opera in New York. And if you want to join that course and you want to you are a violinist and or a violin player of whatever level and you would like to learn the viola. I'm really tired, I notice. And when I'm tired, my English gets like really bad. So let's just details are in the description. I'll write a description when I had a cup of coffee. So this was fun. And if you have further questions about learning the viola as a violinist, then please leave them in the comments below. And I'll make sure to be well caffeinated when I answer those questions. So there's only one word that still can't come out of my mouth. And that is bye-bye.